down and troubled, and you need a helping hand, and nothing, oh nothing, is going right. Close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even your darkest nights.
Hello, this is our digital service of worship for Somerset Mendip, our weekly service put together by David, to which we give our thanks. We're going to begin our service, wherever you're watching, at whatever time you're watching, with a call to worship. And our worship is based on this particular piece of scripture. For where two or three are gathered in my name, there am I in the midst of them. So we pray. Lord, this day, wherever we are gathered, we need your presence within our shared journeys. We come from all walks of life, from different places. So stand amongst us, remind us of who we are and how our worship should be one of joy and thanksgiving for the love that you have given to each of us. Amen. And so we begin our worship in song by singing the hymn 342, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. 342.
With your daughter.
so let us bow our heads in prayer. Let us pray. Almighty and loving God, we gather at this time and place in our homes to praise you for the wonders we behold each day. We pause in the stillness to reflect on the beauty of the world around us, the freshness of the air we breathe, the clear life-giving water we receive each day, the freedoms we enjoy. You alone, Lord, create new life and bring peace. And for all these things, we praise your holy name. We give thanks for our shared lives, for the wonderful blessings that we often take for granted, for the gifts of one another, and for our shared support to others through and by the love found through this fellowship with Jesus Christ. We give thanks for the gift of time to hear your word within our hearts, for friendship and for a peace like no other, if we care to receive it. And yet so often, Lord, we fail you in so many ways. We think unkind thoughts about others, and we sometimes place our needs above all else. We stand before you laid bare of the many things we do wrong in your sight. But faithful God, a God of great love and mercy, your love was so great that you sent your Son Jesus Christ to show us your holy ways. So we are here gathered, knowing that we can be forgiven, renewed and restored, called to be transformed by such love, secure in the knowledge that we are yours always. So may we follow you in faith and make a difference in the world around us, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our first reading this morning is taken from the Psalm 126, and Mary will now share that reading with us.
Psalm 126, a song for pilgrims ascending to Jerusalem. When the Lord brought back his exiles to Jerusalem, it was like a dream. We were filled with laughter and we sang for joy. And the other nations said, "What amazing things the Lord has done for them. Yes, the Lord has done amazing things for us. What joy! Restore our fortunes, Lord, as streams renew the desert. Those who plant in tears will harvest with shouts of joy. They weep as they go to plant their seed, but they sing as they return with the harvest."
We will worship once more in song by singing our hymn number 75, "From All That Dwell Beneath the Skies." And following our hymn, Deborah will lead us in our gospel reading, which is taken from the Gospel of Mark. Hymn 75.
Through every land, by every tongue, reading is from Mark chapter 10, verses 46 to 52. He came to Jericho, and as he was leaving the town with his disciples, a large crowd, Bartimaeus, that is the son of Timaeus, a blind beggar, was seated at the roadside. Hearing that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout, "Son of David, Jesus, have pity on me." Many other people told him to hold his tongue, but he shouted all the more, "Son of David, have pity on me." Jesus stopped and said, "Call him." So they called the blind man. "Take heart," they said. "Get up. He is calling you." At that, he threw off his cloak, jumped to his feet, and came to Jesus. Jesus said to him, "What do you want me to do for you?" "Rabbi," the blind man answered, "I want my sight back." Jesus said to him, "Go, your faith has healed you." And at once he recovered his sight and followed him on the road. Amen.
You know, I remember when I first saw my dog, Dizzy, who's quite elderly now. And I'd gone to Wiltshire to look at another animal. In fact, there were several animals in this foster home. And Dizzy was the unexpected one. And as I was looking at all the other dogs and everybody was going crazy around me trying to get my attention, Dizzy sort of slid in between all these other dogs very quietly. And she wasn't much to look at. She had no hair on her back. She was skin and bone. You could see her ribs. There were scars on her body because she was a rescue animal. And she just crawled up onto my knee and looked at me. And my heart melted. And I remember mumbling out loud, "Well, you're not a lot to look at." But the dog had already won my heart. And with compassion, I thought, yes, that's the one for me. And that dog, and I've had 10 animals, that dog is and was the best I've ever had. It was circumstance, Dizzy's persistence, her vulnerability, but also she has repaid me with faithfulness and love and follows me. Our gospel reading is about Bartimaeus, the blind beggar, who was living in a time when there was no assistance for those without sight. And this was no easy life. He had to resort to begging. They were the forgotten, powerless people of the world. Bartimaeus had found his way to the side of the road where he knew the crowds would pass by during the day. He would beg from morning until night and hope for enough to be given to him that he could live for another day. And yet on this day, an encounter with Jesus would change his life forever. There is a strong analogy in all the Gospels between physical sight and spiritual sight. Jesus says of those who do not receive his words, "This is why I speak to them in parables. Though seeing, they do not see. Though hearing, they do not hear or understand." The healing of Bartimaeus is the last healing miracle in Mark's gospel. It is significant that this healing miracle has to do with the restoration of sight. Bartimaeus recognized Jesus for who he was, even though he was physically unsighted. Bartimaeus has insight into who Jesus actually is. He calls out to the Son of David. And strangely, Jesus does not challenge this identification. The crowds around him try to silence Bartimaeus, but Jesus does not. Our own spiritual journeys begin in earnest when we truly recognize Jesus Christ for who he is and who he can be in our lives. Bartimaeus was persistent because there were some in the crowd who sternly ordered him to be quiet. And whatever the reason, Bartimaeus kept on calling. He was calling out to the one that could bring healing. He did not deviate from this, and Jesus' compassion was there for all to witness. You see, the crowds were wrong. Jesus stopped everything to go to Bartimaeus, to think about the obstacles that Jesus had to overcome in doing that simple act. He had a handful of followers who did not fully understand his mission. And there were detractors in the crowd who were present all the way to Jerusalem and the waiting cross. But Jesus knew that he was about to enter a time of harsh reality, a time of trials, of pain and adversity. But still he stops. Is that not encouragement to all of us? The truth is, Christ cares for each and every one of us as if there is only one to care for. The encounter between Jesus and Bartimaeus leads to commitment in hearing the promise of the risen Christ. Notice this quiet, but momentous little passage in our gospel reading. Jesus says, "Go, your faith has made you well." And Bartimaeus' response? Immediately he regains his sight. And here's the important bit. And followed him on his way. When we truly understand the work of Christ in our lives, it will be the most natural thing of all to want to follow him. Following Jesus must become our way. Bartimaeus' story begins alongside the road, but ends up as a follower of Jesus on the road. The shift of emphasis reflects Bartimaeus' move from the invisible margins of our society to the heart of the gospel story. But healing stories, especially those that call attention to a sufferer's faith, can present difficulties to us all. There are dangers in drawing simplistic connections between faith and healing. We cannot promise cures. Only what Jesus promises on the way that leads to the cross. And the heart of this message is that God is close to us in every circumstance. No matter how solid we may be in our faith, there is always room for improvement. For the modern world around us is anything but static. It's dynamic, it's changing, always on the move. And if we are to take seriously the needs of the world, we have to be engaged in an ongoing process of revitalization and renewal. Think of it this way. To be reformed is to be formed again and again in the image of God and in the likeness of Jesus Christ. And this applies to us all as individuals and for us as a circuit and different congregations. The question is, how do we go about being reformed? The basic steps to being reformed are evident here. Bartimaeus, instead of going back to the life he understood, became a disciple and followed Jesus to Jerusalem. He would never go back to his old way of life again. Presumably, he became a witness to the resurrection and a voice proclaiming the promise of new life in Christ to all who believe. He would face the challenges such a proclamation would bring to him in his new life. And once Bartimaeus could really see beyond the physical, he devoted his life to Jesus Christ. And this is what I'd like to leave you with. Being reformed is not complete until we leave the past behind to embrace the future God has in store for us. Christ makes all things new, including us, including our circuit, including our churches, in ways perhaps we don't really understand, or more importantly, ways we do not want. We're never going to be the center of the universe, but we all have a place and a role to play. And we must take up that role to follow on in our own path in the love of God. to truly desire to be in the presence of Jesus and follow his path and not our own. Bartimaeus, although blind, has truly seen Jesus and knows who he is. And that vision moves him out of despair into this new life. And Jesus commends Bartimaeus for recognizing who he is with the eyes of faith and grants him physical sight as well. Remember, Bartimaeus appealed to Jesus, "Let me see again." And yet, for both you and I, it will be a different plea this day. Jesus is speaking to us all. What do you want me to do for you? How will we respond? We ask that the Lord stops, is present with us in these moments, to hear each one of us today as we cry out to him with our own needs in search of that peace in a busy world. So my prayer for you all today is that you find this peace and in faith rise up and follow the one who continues to call, "Come, follow me." And at once they left their own ways and followed him. May we all have the courage to do the same. In Jesus' name, amen. So we come to our prayers of intercession. So we pray. Almighty God, we hear your word. Find those who are lost. Lord, who protects the flock and searches tirelessly for those who wander from the fold, retrieve those who are lost in society and bring them home to your love and your care. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heal those broken in spirit. Loving God, wrap your blessings around those who are brokenhearted, depressed, or feeling that no one really cares about them. Fill their hearts with your peace, your joy, and your love. We think of those afflicted with illness, those who are bereaved, and those who are fearful, especially in this COVID world that we live in. We bring to mind those in need of your healing spirit and name them in the quiet of our hearts and minds. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We hear your call to feed the hungry. Faithful God, we pray for everyone who is hungry this day, both spiritually and physically. Those who are far away, or those within our local communities. We pray for those who share this earth with us, all those who have nothing, and those, even in today's world, have very little to eat. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, who has created each one of us in your own image, give us grace to fight against the evil in the world around us as you call us to release the oppressed. Help us to use the freedom we enjoy to enjoy justice in our communities and throughout the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Call us to bring peace among all peoples, to create a God, we pray, for those countries that are being torn apart by violence, by war, by terrorist acts. All those places that remain in conflict and in uncertainty. May your power bring about change that will bring peace and restoration for both population and community alike. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. May we be the ones who radiate the light of Christ every day, in every way, in all that we do and how we behave. May we speak as joyful disciples of the Lord we serve. Merciful Father, accept these our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Saviour, who asks us to share together this prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We bring our worship to a close by singing our final hymn in the hymn book. It's 295. Alleluia, Alleluia, give thanks to the risen Lord. Hymn number 295.
Let us praise the living.
And so our final blessing. May there be within this day quiet moments when you sit at the feet of the Lord and just listen. Times of stillness when you know the Lord your God is beside you. May Christ's love and peace flow through your very soul. And may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with us and remain with us always. Amen.
You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running, yeah, to see you again. Winter, spring,